Python loops, they sound so simple, don't they, right? But even experienced programmers and beginners can get them wrong. And I'm going to show you four common Python loop mistakes that can slow your code down, cause unexpected bugs, or even crash your program. So let's jump into our editor and fix these mistakes right now. So here I am, I'm inside Visual Studio Code. And let's talk about the first thing that you could do wrong. Mistake one, modifying a list while iterating over it. Now, this is actually fairly common for beginners. And if you've done this before, you may not have been able to understand what's gone wrong. And one of the biggest issues is that sometimes you can have accidental successes and you think everything's fine, when in fact, there is something belying this which is wrong. Let me create a very basic example here. Let me create a list with 5 integers. Okay, very basic list. Now, what if I wanted to iterate over this list? And if the number is even, I'm going to remove it. So I might try something like this. For num in numbers, I would say if num modulo with 2 is equal to 0, which indicates that it is even, I want to do something. And what do I want to do? I want to do the following. I want to remove it. Numbers dot remove num. Fair enough. That seems easy. Now let's print out what we've got left. So in this instance, what do we expect to see? What we hope to see is 1, 3, and 5. You want to get rid of 2 and 4. So if I save this and run it now, do we get that? Let's head over to our terminal and let's run this code. And we get 1, 3, and 5. Everything seems to be fine. It's working fine, right? There's nothing that needs changing. That's actually not the case, because what's going on here is that we're accidentally succeeding. Because when we remove 2, we're shifting the list left. And when we're shifting elements along and we're iterating over them, we can end up skipping elements and things are about to fall apart. And how can I prove this to you? Okay, let me make one change to this. What if I add an additional 2? Okay, now let's save this and rerun this. What do we expect to see? What we want to see is 1, 3, and 5. We've got 2 twos and a 4. They're all even. They should be removed, right? Okay, let's find out if that's the case. Let's rerun this and what do we get? 1, 2, 3, 5. Oh no, what's gone wrong? This is my point. It is failing. This is not working properly. You're iterating over while modifying the list. This is not going to work because the elements are being shifted along as you do this. This is not the way to handle it. How can we fix this? Okay, there's two ways you could do it. Either create a copy or use a list comprehension. And I'm going to show you the list comprehension. It's my preference because it is very Pythonic. So let's say, for instance, we take our numbers again. Let's copy down here, make a new variable. So we're resetting it essentially to the original. And let's use a very basic list comprehension. And we're going to say the following within this list comprehension. We're going to say for num in numbers, if num does not equal, or rather if num modulo 2 does not equal 0, then we want to do something. Okay, we want to keep it, don't we? Because that means that it is, there we go, not even. So we're keeping everything that isn't even. So it's just a slightly different way of wording it. We're saying if modulo 2 is not equal to 0, it means that it isn't even. So let's keep that number. If it isn't, bin it. So that's it. That should work. So if I print that, hopefully this is going to work as we'd expect. I'm printing out 2. I've got 2 print statements here. This one should be incorrect. This one should be correct. Okay, so let me just double check. Everything looks okay in there. Yep, I think we are good to go. So let's go back to our terminal, hit run. What do we get? The list comprehension works as expected. So the short message is here that if you want to change a list while iterating over it, your options are to create a copy or use a list comprehension. Really simple. Okay, so we're back in the terminal. We're rather back in Visual Studio Code. Let's delete this, or we'll comment it all out for now. Let's talk about mistake number 2. This is using the range function with the length of a list to iterate over that rather than using enumerate. Now, a lot of people do this when looping through a list with an index, but it's really not the way to do it. There's a cleaner way with enumerate. So I'm going to show you the non-clean way, then the clean way. So let's imagine we've got a new list called fruits. Let's create our list, and we're going to have, for instance, within that, an apple. Ooh, let's make sure we actually made that list. An apple, banana, and what else could we have? Cherry. Great. That is our list of fruits. Now, how do I iterate over this? Okay, here's one thing I could do. So I want to loop through this. It's a list with an index. I could say for I in range, and then the length of fruits. I could then print out the following, I and the element at that index. Okay, so make sure we've got I. Okay, so this probably looks quite familiar if you're used to coding something like C++, maybe not C++, but something where you're used to using I variables. But the point I would like to point out is that whilst this is going to work, this is not very clean. This is not very Pythonic. And the more Pythonic way to do that is to use enumerate, which gives you both the index and the value without having to call the len function. Because this is kind of ugly. What's cleaner? Let's have a look at this. So we could just say for I and fruit in enumerate, we could do the following. Print I and fruit. Now, this is going to be the same output, but look at the two. Which looks cleaner to you? Which looks more Pythonic? I mean, hopefully you're saying number two. It should be. Now, I'm going to save this and run it just to prove that they'll give the same output. But just for the sake of argument, there you go. Everything is the same. The output to the user is unchanged. When you're writing code and you're writing Pythonic code, this is the way to do it. This is definitely not the way to do it. Okay, so use enumerate instead of range with the len of the list if you want to use the index. Okay, pretty simple. Okay, mistake three. Using while true without a break condition. Yeah, infinite loops are useful, but they need a proper exit condition. I know that sounds really common and really obvious, but don't create an infinite loop without an exit condition. So we're back in Visual Studio Code. I am going to comment this all out and let's talk about this mistake. So let's imagine I've created a simple infinite loop while true. I'm going to say user input is equal to input, and I'm going to say enter, make sure that is string. Make sure that is a string using double quotes because we're going to be using single quotes in a moment. Enter Q to quit. Okay, so the user has to enter Q to quit. All right, and we can say the following. If user input is equal to Q, break. Now that looks okay, I guess on the surface, right? So we've offered up an issue or a way for the user to quit. And whilst this works, if there's an issue with the user input or logic, it might run forever. And that's bad, okay? You don't want something that's running forever. So here is a cleaner way to do it, all right? So what we could say is the following. Let's create this setup. So user input blank string, okay? And we could say while user input does not equal Q, then we enter into our loop. And then we can gather our user input again. And we can essentially have the same thing that we had over here. Enter Q to quit. But the second one is much more Pythonic. Okay, now whilst they look similar, and they do look similar, this is a more Pythonic way to do it. And I think that if you are entering into any infinite loops, make sure that you have a proper exit condition. And this is a better way to structure those scenarios. Okay, great. Now, of course, bear in mind, these while loops have nothing going on. All we're doing is asking user for input, which is fairly boring. What you would expect to see is there'd be something going on in here. There'd be some logic, there'd be something your program needs to do, and the exit condition handling is purely for exiting the loop. Just wanted to point that out. You thought, what's the point of this while loop? It's an infinite loop that does nothing. But yeah, it's just a scaffolding for adding an infinite loop. Okay, so let's move on to mistake number four. And mistake number four, I'm going to comment this out so we can move on down. So looping over a dictionary the hard way. Okay, so if you're working with dictionaries in Python, and why wouldn't you? They're amazing. I love a key value store, and dictionaries are awesome for that. So fast as well. Absolutely brilliant. But you might be doing something unnecessarily. So let's create a basic dictionary called data. And within this dictionary, we'll have the name, and then we will say it is Alice. And then we'll have age, and we'll say 25. Okay, super basic dictionary. Now, how am I going to iterate over this? Here's one thing I could do. I could say for key in data dot keys, I could print out the following key and data passing in the key. Okay, that works. That does work. That's fine. But Python gives you a better way to loop over keys and values. And if you already know how to use dot keys, you should probably know this already. But in case you don't, you would do the following. You would say for key value in data.items, that's the difference. We're using the items method there, or accessor, and we're just going to say the following, print key value. Okay, now look at the two. They both achieve the same thing, but which one is more Pythonic? Clearly this, as opposed to that. It's a bit like our while loop situation, or using enumerate instead of range with the len. It's just a more Pythonic, cleaner way to achieve the same output. I'll run this and you'll see exactly the same thing, but the point is that if you're going to write Pythonic code, this is what you want to do rather than making this very obvious mistake. Okay, so let's save this, head on over to the terminal, run this. And as you expect, they have the same result. But again, the user output is unchanged. But as a coder, this is what you should be doing, not this. So there you have it. Loops are powerful, but small mistakes they can lead to big problems, whether that is just ugly code or even actual errors. Maybe code that runs forever, who knows what it is, but fixing these common errors will make your Python code cleaner, faster, and also easier to read. You've got to think about your other developers. They want to be able to read your code and understand what it is you're doing. And writing Pythonic and clean, easy to read code is a skill that you should definitely look to master. So I hope that you like this video. Please feel free to let me know in the comments if there's anything that you'd like me to answer or expand upon. And as always, feel free to hit like, subscribe, any of that stuff. But thanks for watching, and I can't wait to see you in the next video.